And welcome to S-Ray. So today in this video, I'll be presenting the solution to the complicated practice questions that was given as assignment in the videos relating to simple interest and compound interest. So this is your part 3 of interest. So let's begin. What annual installment will discharge a debt of 1092 due in 3 years at 12% interest? The answer was 325. So most of you might be wondering, how can 325 rupees will discharge a debt of 1092, because 325 into 3 makes about 975, and this is less than 1092, and it is like this answer might be wrong. But let me tell you, I'm speaking about interest. This is something related to banking. Assume I have taken some money from the bank. Okay, let me not say about taking money. Assume I am depositing some money in the bank. What will bank do? Will the bank keep the money as it is, safe? No, right? The bank will lend this money to someone else who is in need, and it will charge some interest on that money. So, with that interest, that bank will also provide you the interest, right? So that whenever you deposit some money in the bank, after few years or after some time, you will be getting interest for the money which you have deposited. This also works the same way. Assume each installment I am making is X rupees. So this is 3 annual installments. After first year, I am making an installment of X rupees. So when I make an installment of X rupees, I must make still 2 more installments. That is, 2 years are left. So for this X rupees, the bank will be getting interest for 2 years at the rate of 12% per annum. So the simple interest, if you calculate it, is X into 2 into 12 by 100. So this is the interest which bank will be gaining for my first installment. Okay. And for the second installment, since it is for 1 more year, bank will be gaining X into 1 into 12 by 100. So this is my first installment and interest for the first installment, second installment and the interest for the second installment, and third installment. With the third installment, I'll be getting discharged of my debt, so it will not lend me any interest. So I'm having this much money which will get me discharged of 1092 rupees. I hope you understood this concept. So when I simplify these equations, I'll be getting 28x plus 31x plus 25x is equals to 1092 into 25. So I have skipped some steps and I want you to work it out and come to this step. And finally, when you solve for x, you'll be getting x to be equal to 325 rupees. So it is not wrong. The answer is absolutely right. Just the thing is, you should think broadly. Think out of the box. It's not thinking out of the box. It is just thinking in depth. Whenever I pay some installment, I must get some interest for that installment which I have paid, for the money which I am giving. So that is what will add up to your installment, the interest, and that will get you rid of 1092 rupees. And I hope you have understood this concept. So let us have a look at the next question. Find the difference between simple interest and compound interest for 2 years at 15% on 15,000. So this is one of the favorite question of many aptitude question paper setters. So you might be thinking, like, you have to work out for simple interest, you have to find compound interest, and then you will come at a solution. But no, there is only one step by which you can get the answers. So here the answer is 337.5. The simple step is, like, the difference between simple interest and compound interest for n years at r percent on principal p is given by p into r by 100 power n. Okay, so here p is 15,000 and r is 5%. Sorry, it must be 15%. And so when you solve this, you'll be getting 337.5. Okay, so there's just a mistake that it should have been 15. Here it is written 5. Okay, When you solve 15,000 into 15 by 100 square, the answer is 337.5. So don't forget this formula. P into R by 100 power N will give you the difference between simple interest and compound interest for N years at the rate of R percent per annum. So yeah, these two were the more complicated questions, and this was the simple technique which I wanted to present. And with this, I'll be finishing the videos on interest. Thank you. Have a nice day. And if you believe that you are getting benefited by these videos, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Enjoy learning. Bye-bye.